As you reach to push open the heavy door, the coils and whirls of engraved wood dance into a new pattern. The semblance of a face arises, a face that seems to look right through you.
A little sorcerer, come to play. You are a sorcerer, are you not? Perhaps even godwoken. Tell me true now.
Silence greets your answer. In the distance, you hear the screech of an eagle. Worryingly closer, you hear some kind of a moan. Time passes. At last, the lips on the door creak open and the door speaks.
Enter.
The face melts back into the wood of the door, and the whirls swirl back into a floral pattern. A loud metallic click can be heard from deep within.
Builds a mansion on the edge of a graveyard.
What's this? I found something.
A visitor? Such a rare and exquisite pleasure.
The elf tilts his head backwards, but his squinted eyes don't stray from yours.
Call me Riker. Please, do avail yourself of my creature comforts. You've surely come a long way. It's not an ordinary location, I admit, but I prefer to be extraordinary. There is no pleasure in mediocrity. Don't you agree, Godwoken? Don't be so naive. My doors only open on the occasion of truth. What you admit to them, you admit to me. I also see you are not yet whole.
He presses a slender forefinger against his tight lips and hums.
I'm not a generous man, but I could give you what you seek if you offer something in return. A completely fair exchange between sorcerers. Let's not be so secretive, my good fellow. You're dying to show off those smoldering talents of yours. You just don't know how to handle them. I can help you with that. I can share my bond with the source with you, fill your well to the brim, make you a master. The rest of the story, well, it's yours to write. You must go to the Black Pits. There's a cavern there. In it, you'll find a stone tablet of considerable value.
He points to the location on your map.
Bring it to me.
Dizziness. It lasts just a moment, but long enough for you to feel Ralik's presence. You hear no words, yet understand. It's imperative you accept Riker's bargain. The episode passes. Riker is peering at you intently. He awaits your reply.
Oh, but heading to the Black Pits would mean tangling with more magisters, and they're such a nuisance. I like keeping my hands clean, you see. It's a miracle of the ancients. Priceless, really, and powerful enough to draw the magisters' attentions. I won't bore you with further detail. Suffice it to say, it is safer in my hands than in theirs.
Riker's lips stretch and his cheeks bulge, but you couldn't rightly call his unusual grimace a smile.
I'm a man of taste, as you no doubt see. A relic this significant would make an incredible addition to my collection. Don't deny an old elf his simple pleasures. How marvelous.
Riker's lips tremble impatiently as his eyes dart to your pack.
Show it to me.
He considers you for a moment.
Very well.
Riker closes his eyes and spreads his arms, then begins to recite a vivid incantation.
I call to the souls of the dead. Your remains, the stone garden's eternal burden, descend from the hall. Surrender your source to the vessel before me.
Riker's voice grows even louder until his words echo from every crevice in the chamber.
Swan and Rince, Crossley and Locke, Quincy, Keller, Harkwood, Haran, an essence yours no longer, souls and source come forth. Cross to the void, so that he might awaken.
The words wrap themselves around you, then slip through your pores. You feel as if you could skate upon water or leap among the clouds. You are no longer less, but more.
Your well overflows, Godwoken. But I will stay as true to my word as I can. Accept this gift from the spirits of the Stone Garden in lieu of the mastery you already possess, and thus I can no longer offer. Now that you mention it, there is one other promise I need to keep. A shame it has to be this way. I was just getting...
Huh!
to none. Won't be the first double cross. I'm a wanted man.
The spirit's lips curl into a...
Don't look so pleased with yourself. You're too quick to act, too green still. Your bond with the source may be strengthened, but you are hardly prepared for divinity. I've nothing left to show you and nothing left to say. Take what you must. But my remaining memories and masteries, they are mine alone.
His sneer is now a gash, wide and gruesome. You can barely believe. And you thought Rivellon was flat.
Death prowls above.
I've spotted something.
The cat and the dog appear to be arguing.
Moo! Moo!
If you think the master loves you more than he loves me, then, Dot, you're a bigger idiot than you look.
Master's the master. Master knows the dog is better than the cat. Master says good dog. Does master say good cat? No. No, master does not. See?
The cat gives the dog a long, languid look of carefully disguised contempt. Then she sighs and turns to you.
Settle an argument for us. Dog's body here thinks that because the master is grateful for his, meaning the dog's, mindless devotion, he loves his dog more than he loves his cat. I, on the other hand, know full well that it's the master's admiration for my general bearing, demeanour and intrinsic greatness what is most indicative of a state of actual love. He near worships me, he does.
Master loves his dog. Master thinks his cat is cool, not the same thing.
You're a moron.
No, I'm not. I'm Black Brown.
See what I'm dealing with? Come on, settle the argument. Tell him he's wrong. There you go, Dot. Listen to the nice fellow.
I don't get it. Dog.
Oh.
Dog.
Oh, you're impossible.
Take you.
The air buzzes with sauce here.
Flesh and bone, severed and stitched. Perhaps some sort of necromancy?
Careful. I've spotted a trap. This is quite the antiques collection.
Nice.
This is quite the antiques collection.
Look out! I see a trap nearby.
Ah, I hear a door opening. Careful. I've spotted a trap. All this knowledge hidden from inquisitive minds. Such a pity. I can feel my source powers
My lucky day. A third pyramid.
The lizard hums tunelessly. Not a melody exactly, but more of a meandering moan.
10 spans under, humans slept. 10 spans up, the dwarves were kept. Lizards burn.
She looks to your left with one eye.
It helps me remember. Sometimes they...
She smiles at you with the innocence of a newborn. She flinches.
No, no.
Her humming fades.
Riker might get mad. He doesn't like it when someone...
The lizard pauses. And a smile crosses her face.
Me belongs to me. Servants belong to the hall. That's the way I like it.
Her hum returns, soft at first, then blossoming into a full-fledged hymn.
10 spans under, humans slept.
She pointedly ignores you. She pointedly ignores you. She pointedly ignores. She pointedly ignores.
I've spotted something.
Vault looks unfinished. Was it never used?
abomination. Was it the death fog that got them, or something else? Is mine.
to none.
Thank you.
mine. Your maker.
Thank you.
almost got me that time.
Be grateful that you don't feel the need.
Your branches and ravish your roots until you squeal.
Ear, ear, stadaga naga, ear, utradaga.
Your name, stand back! Not a foot on these stairs. Whatever words you carry. We will burn you leaf by leaf, vein by vein. We will flay your every last strip of bark until you bow to the ring.
Ear, ear, stadaga naga, ear utradaga.
Your name, relent to the ring and yield your name.
Hurts, doesn't it?
Thank you.
yield to none. Prepare yourself.
Thank you. Baker.
Resume your business.
My, you were rather more astute than my initial verdict. A stirring display of violence. As per our terms. The location...
The lizard leans in close, his rancid breath clogging your throat. As you look into the darkness of his eyes, you see an island. You see the winds that will carry you there. You see the way.
Now, Godwoken, we both have what we sought, and thus all guarantees of safety are expired. You need not fear me, but this island hides more dangers than my claws. I recommend you go. But should I find you broken on the beach, I will shed no tears. It is something of a relic. A relic that has had its spirit defiled by the Black Ring. Now, I have work to do. This place must be cleansed, it must be healed. And you must surely know that your welcome is wearing thin.
Can you feel it? The twisted pain. It's everywhere.
They didn't die quietly. How satisfying.
Leor Ruvola and Cree. Areno Rotomiso.
How fares the hunt, my friend?
His dark eyes grow darker still.
All you had to do is say no, remember? Here you stand, a child of the Seven, and yet you chose to deal with a demon. There is no word for such stupidity. But I will teach you a lesson yet.
They didn't die quietly. How satisfying.
Hmm.
Reoruvola and Cree. Areno Rotomiso.
Tree.
Gotta get back.
Well now, how's my favorite?
If Anne claps you on the the elf squelches her feet in the red mass.
My thanks, even after... My thanks. With balance restored, even after all...
Dear me, have you lost your path? Simply choose a direction and ambulate until you strike the shore.
Can you feel it? The twisted pain. It's everywhere.
They didn't die quietly. How satisfying.
Once there, well, perhaps you should keep walking on that course. Areno Rotomiso.
My thanks, even after.
They didn't die quietly. How satisfying.
Reoruvola and Cree. Areno Rotomiso.
The twisted pain. It's everywhere.